Hello, Sairam students. Okay, now in the last class, we have already done about the types of triangles. We already studied about the types of triangles which were categorized on the basis of the sides and angles. Today, we'll be doing the last topic of this chapter. So, in part 5, so we'll be doing about the properties of triangles. So the first property of the triangle says that the sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. That means when you add the measurement of the angle P, angle Q and angle R. Yes. Suppose if you are taking angle P has 70 degree. Angle R has, sorry, angle Q has 80 degree. So 70 plus 80 is 150. So, your measurement of angle R should be 30 degree. That is 70 plus 30 plus 80, it should come up to 180. If the sum of the three angles is 180 degree, that means you can form a triangle. Okay. But if the sum of the three angles of a triangle is less than 180 or more than 180 degree, the triangle cannot be formed. Okay. So, this is the first property. What it says is that the sum of the three angles when you add, it should be 180 degree. Let us see an example based on this. Okay, the first example is the measurement of one angle is 100 degree. The second one is 50 degree and the third one is 30 degree. You have to find out whether a triangle can be formed. Now, here one angle is obtuse, that is 100 degree, and the other two angles are acute angles. Now, when you add the three angles, that is 100 plus 50 plus 30, it has come to 180 degree. That means with this measurement, you can form a triangle. Okay, so remember children, when you add all the three measurements of the angles, it should come to 180 degree. If it does not come to 180, if it is less than 180 degree or more than 180 degree, you cannot form a triangle. But if the measurement is 180 degree after adding, that means you can form a triangle. Here when you add 100 degree plus 50 plus 30, it is coming up to 180 degree. That means you can form a triangle with this measurement. Okay. Let us see one more example. Okay, now here the measurement of the angles are given as 110 degree, 95 degree and 20 degree. That means two obtuse angle and one acute angle. Okay, so sum of the three angles when you add, now when you add 110 plus 95 plus 20, you are getting the answer as 225, which is greater than 180. That means, can you form a triangle? No, you cannot form a triangle. So, with this measurement, that is 110, 95 and 20 degree, you cannot form a triangle. Okay? Okay, now always remember that children, a triangle cannot have more than one obtuse or right angle. That is, a triangle will always have, can have only one obtuse angle or one right angle, and also one angle of a triangle must be 60 degree or more. With less than that, you cannot form a triangle. Okay, so always remember these two points, that a triangle cannot have more than one obtuse angle. Now in the previous example, we have seen that there were two obtuse angle, so you cannot form a triangle. So a triangle cannot have more than one obtuse or right angle, and also remember that one angle of a triangle must be 60 degree or more. Now, based on this, let us solve some examples of exercise 12.3, which you have to note it down or copy it down. Solve it in your notebook. Okay. Exercise 2.3. Sum is a second sum. You have to find whether a triangle can be formed with the given angles or not. The measurement of the angles are given here. Okay. 54 degree, 75 degree and 36 degree. Now here what you are going to write is sum of the three angles. That is, sum means you will add. When you add all the three measurement of the angles, that is 54 plus 75 plus 36, the answer what you get is 165. Okay, so that means, can you form a triangle? It is less than 180 degree. So what does your first property says? That your first property tells you that the sum of all the three angles should sum up to 180 degree. But here it is less than 180 degree. So you cannot form a triangle. So a triangle cannot be formed. Okay, so you have to write that as 165 degree is less than 180 degree, you cannot form a triangle, or a triangle cannot be formed. Okay, coming to the next sum. Okay, B1, here again the three measurements are given: 105 degree, 35 degree and 40 degree. Now here when you add all the three measurement of the angles, that is 105 plus 35 plus 40, what is the answer you get? You get your answer has 180 degree. Now when you, your first property tells you that the sum of the three angles, when you add, it should be 180 degree. So here when you add, you are getting 180 degree. That means a triangle can be formed. Okay? Yes. Coming to the next sum, E1. Here again the measurement of the three angles, 68 degree, 110 degree and 22 degree. One obtuse angle and two acute angles. Now when you add all the three measurements, 68 plus 110 plus 22, what you are getting is, you are getting the answer has 200 degree. Now 200 is more than 180. That means you cannot form a triangle, or you can say that a triangle cannot be formed. So exactly when you add all the three measurements, 3 degrees, you should get 180 degree. Only if you get 180 degree, that means you can form a triangle. If it is less than 180 or more than 180 degree, you cannot form a triangle. Okay, this is what your first property tells you. Okay, now coming to the second property of the triangle. Now here can you see triangle PQR? Okay, now here your second property tells you that the sum of the lengths of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the length of the third side. That means when you add any two sides, suppose if you are adding PQ plus QR, if you are adding, it should be greater than the side PR. Okay. The next what it tells is, if you are adding the other two sides, that is QR plus PR, or you can say PQ plus PR, PQ and PR. If you are adding these two sides, it should be greater than this side, that is QR. So any two sides, if you are adding, it should be always greater than the third side. Okay, this is what your property tells. That is, the sum of the lengths of any two sides of a triangle must be greater than the length of the third side. So let us see an example based on this. If the measure of angles is not given, okay, but the measure of sides is given, then using this property we can find out whether a triangle can be formed or not. Okay, so based on the sides as well as the based on the measure of angles, we can find out whether a triangle can be formed. If the measure of the angles is not given, we will take the measure of the sides. Let us see an example based on this second property. Okay, now here the measurement of the sides is given, that is the measure of three sides, 6 centimeter, 4 centimeter and 5 centimeter. Now suppose this is a triangle. Okay, so measure of one side is 6 centimeter, measure of the other side is 4 centimeter, and the measure of the third side is 5 centimeters. And if I name it as X, Y and Z. Now suppose when we, if I add the two, any two sides, that is suppose if I add XY plus YZ, that means 6 plus 4, it is 10 centimeter, which is greater than XZ, that is 5 centimeter. Again, if I take the other two side, that is XY 6 centimeter, okay, and XZ 5 centimeter. So 6 plus 5 gives me 11 centimeter, which is greater than the third side, that is YZ, which is 4 centimeter. Okay, now coming to the next side, that is 4 centimeter plus 5 centimeter, that is YZ plus XZ. If I add these two sides, YZ plus XZ, that is 4 plus 5, it again comes to 9 centimeter, which is greater than the third side, that is XY, which is 6 centimeter. So that means when you add any two sides of the triangle, it is greater than the third side. That means a triangle can be formed. Okay, so keep this in mind that any two sides when you add, it should always be greater than the third side. Let us see one more example. Yes. Now here the three sides are 3 centimeter, 10 centimeter and 6 centimeter. Okay, now here when we add, here when we add 3 centimeter, suppose if you are taking it in a triangle, suppose if I draw a triangle here and name it as A, B and C. Now here when I add, suppose AB is 3 centimeter, BC is 10 centimeter and if I take the other side, AC has 6 centimeter. Now when I add AB, okay, when I add AB, that is 3 centimeter and 10 centimeter, that is BC. So 3 plus 10 is 13, which is greater than 6 centimeter. Okay, here when you are adding 3 plus 10, you are getting 13 centimeter, which is greater than 6 centimeter. But at the same time, if you are taking the other side, that is 3 centimeter and 6 centimeter. Now, if I am taking AB and AC, if I am adding 3 plus 6, that is 9 centimeter, it is smaller than this base, that is 10 centimeter. Okay, that means as the sum of the two sides, 3 centimeter and 6 centimeter, is less than the third side. Now here we are getting the, when we add, we are getting less than the third side. So a triangle cannot be formed. Okay, so a triangle cannot be formed. But why? Because your second property tells you that when you are adding any two sides of a triangle, it should always be greater than the third side. Okay, now here based on this, let us start with exercise 12.3, which you have to again do it in your notebook. Now here you have to find whether a triangle can be formed with the given sides. Okay, here the sides are given and not the measures, so you have to find out whether a triangle can be formed with the given sides. Now the measurement of the three sides are given, that is 5 centimeter, 11 centimeter and 9 centimeter. So what you are going to do is, if you want, you can draw a triangle and then just add and see whether you can form a triangle A, B and C. Now suppose one side, if I write it as 5 centimeter, BC 11 centimeter and this AC has 9 centimeter. So let us first add these two sides, that is AB plus BC. If I add 5 centimeter plus 11 centimeter, so 5 plus 11 will give me 16 centimeter, which is greater than the third side, that is 9 centimeter. Okay, now suppose if I take the other two side, if I take it as AB and AC, okay, let me take the other two side. That is AB 5 centimeter plus AC, which is 9 centimeter. So 9 plus 5 is 14 centimeter, which again is greater than the third side, that is 11 centimeter. Okay, so 9 plus 5, which is 14 centimeter, which is greater than the third side, that is 11 centimeter. Now coming to the next side, next two sides, BC, that is 11 centimeter BC plus AC. So 11 plus 9 is 20 centimeter, which again is greater than the third side, that is 5 centimeter. So that is, in any ways, when you add any two sides of a triangle, you are getting the sum greater than the third side. That means a triangle can be formed. So according to the property here, when you add any two sides of a triangle, your sum is greater than the third side. So you can form a triangle using the sides of this triangle. Okay. Now coming to the next one. 12 centimeter, 14 centimeter and 30 centimeter. Now here, if we draw a triangle. Okay, M, N and R. Okay, now the three sides, if I write 12 centimeter, then 14 centimeter, second side, the next side is 30 centimeter. Now here, when we add, for 12 centimeter, let us take the first side MN, 12 centimeter, plus NR, that is 14 centimeter. Now 12 plus 14 is 26. Here you are getting 26, that is, which is less than the third side. Now which is your third side here? MR. So 26 centimeter is less than 30 centimeter. That means triangle cannot be formed. Okay, according to the property, what does it tell? It tells us that when you add any two sides of a triangle, it should be greater than the third side. But here, this 26, it is smaller or less than the third side, that is 30 centimeter. So you cannot form a triangle. Okay, coming to the next sum. Okay, here the measure of the sides is 8 centimeter, 5 centimeter and 10 centimeter. Okay, now if you take any two sides of a triangle, suppose if I draw a triangle here, okay, L, M and N, and if I write the measure of L, M has 8 centimeter, 5 centimeter, M, N and L, N has 10 centimeter. When I add these two sides, LM and MN, 8 centimeter plus 5 centimeter, I get the answer as 13 centimeter, which is greater than the third side, that is 10 centimeter. Now when I add the other two sides of a triangle, if I take the measure of LM, 8 centimeter, and LN has 10 centimeter, so 8 plus 10 is 18 centimeter, which again is greater than the third side, that is 5 centimeter. And the next two sides, that is measure of the side MN, 5 centimeter and 10 centimeter, that is LN. So 10 plus 5 again is 15 centimeter, which is greater than the third side, that is 8 centimeter. So when we add any two sides of a triangle, it is always greater than the third side. So that means a triangle can be formed. Okay. Okay. Now, based on this property of triangles, home assignment for you. You have to find out whether a triangle can be formed with the given angles or not. This is according to the first property. You have to find out whether triangle can be formed with the given angles. Okay. And the second sum is, here you have to find out whether a triangle can be formed with the given sides or not. So this you will be doing it in your homework part. So with this we complete with the chapter 12. So meet you again in the next class with a new chapter. Till then, thank you students and bye bye.